let us say a word of prayer as we prepare to go into the word of the Lord. If you're following me in your Bibles, you can turn your Bibles to the book of Judges chapter 16, and we will start from verses 4. We're just going to read a few verses, and when I begin, we'll do a bit of an overhaul of the entire scripture. Amen. Let us look to the Lord in prayer. Father, we say thank you for all that you are doing. Thank you for all that you are about to do. Thank you for covering our November. We believe that you will do it. We believe that you are doing it. Thank you for covering every person that is on this broadcast, every nation represented here. Thank you, Father, for covering Georgia. Thank you, Father, for covering California, India, Haiti, Africa. Thank you, Father, for covering every nation. Thank you, Father, for covering the islands of the sea. Thank you for covering the Bahamas. And Father, we stand in faith as we believe that you are working in our favor. And the people of God say, amen. And amen. Hallelujah. Persons are still coming in. Good morning to all of you. And of course, we extend our love and greetings from Pastor Trevor Simmons and myself. We love you guys. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Let us look in the word of the Lord from Judges chapter 16. And it reads as thus, and Samson fell in love with a woman in the valley of Sorek, whose name was Delilah. Verse 16. And it came to pass that she pressed him, probed him, and nighed him day after day, that he would reveal the secret of his strength. She did so until he became sick unto death. Verse 17. And he told her all that was in his heart. And he said to her, a razor has not been put in upon my head, for I have been a Nazarene unto God from my mother's womb. If I be shaven, then my strength will go from me, and I shall become weak like any other man. And Delilah told the Philistines, and the Philistines took him and took and put his eyes out, and brought him down to Gaza, and brought him and bound him, with fetters of brass, and he did grind in the prison house. This is the word of the Lord. It is already blessed. Good morning to all of you that are just coming in. Thank you so much. Many of you are about to testify that you have done something in this hard time that you've never done before. I want you to type now, I'm about to testify. Hallelujah. Many are being introduced and reintroduced to their purpose. Purpose is so important to God that he placed it on the inside of your DNA before you were born. There is a move of God that is called process. And process aids our purpose in being discovered and then manifested. It is in the times of process that the enemy uses a weapon. And this weapon is underestimated. The reason why the enemy uses a weapon, I'm going to tell you in just a moment. The reason why the enemy uses this weapon in the times of process is because the Lord will use many methods to discover and manifest our purpose. Some of those methods are painful. and the enemy tries to maximize on our pain. The enemy tries to maximize on what we feel and what we are doubting, glory to God, and what we are doubting. And he tries to do it by causing us to delay our own purpose. He uses a weapon that is underestimated, that is so underestimated that many times we don't even mention it in prayer. It is so underestimated, we don't even see it necessary to fast against it. This weapon is called, are you ready for it? Weariness. Weariness is defined as showing extreme tiredness. So anyone watching me this morning, you feel tired. So once again, weariness is defined by showing extreme tiredness. And so weariness is not just being tired, but it is showing tiredness. Anyone with me this morning? It is showing tiredness. I believe I would rob you if I not also define tiredness. And it was quite intriguing what I learned about tiredness. I'm going to share two reasons we become tired. There are many, but I will give you two of them. Number one, we become tired due to sleep deprivation. It affects our brain and we begin to feel tired. The next reason we feel tired is due to dehydration. I was rather shocked when I saw this, that dehydration can make you feel so tired. You can literally believe, and even though this is serious, you can literally believe something even more serious is going on. My study revealed that whether you are working out or working a desk job, your body needs water to work well. Say, I need water. When you are tired, your body goes through some adverse changes. And I know that we are talking about a natural effect, but I firmly believe and know for a fact that the Lord is using this today to reveal, glory to God, a prophetic message through this word. Amen. When we are tired, these are the things that happen. There are many, but I'll list a few. When you are tired, you cannot perform your duties or responsibilities well. You lack the ability to give your responsibilities all of you, or the best of you. I give a better word. The best of you. And many of you, you are functioning, but you are not effective. Many of you are busy, but you are not producing. And the reason why this is happening is because you are tired. When you are tired, you struggle to pay attention. And so many of you can see what is going on around you, but you are unable to focus on the necessary areas that need your attention, your skill, and your expertise. Glory to God. And so the enemy uses a weapon, I'm going to continue in just a moment, called weariness, to cause you to show tiredness, because he wants to affect or shift your focus. Are you with me today? When you are tired, you struggle to learn new things. Let me say that again. When you are tired, you struggle to learn new things. And so many of you have been placed in a new season, have been given a new opportunity. The Lord is downloading new revelation. And you are struggling with the adjustment period because you're tired. And so you are comfortable sticking with the old or what you know or what you've been comfortable with. And you are unable to move into the new thing because your brain and your spiritual factors, glory to God, your prophetic instinct is now unable to go there in this time because you're tired. And the Spirit of the Lord God is saying, you are in a new time. You are in an era that you've never ever seen before. And I'm trying to download the answers that you've never ever received before. But the enemy has released a weapon called weariness so that you cannot receive the new thing. When you are tired, hear this, y'all. When you are tired, you lose coordination. One of the definitions of coordination is, it is the ability to use the different parts of your body. Glory to God. Spiritually now, we know that we are a part of the body of Christ. And when the church and the people of God become weary, we struggle with how we handle the different members of the body of Christ. Are you with me this morning? Many of you this morning, as a part of the body of Christ, as a part of the church of the living God, you are struggling with how to use your heart. You are giving your heart to the wrong people. You are allowing your heart to be filled with offense and unforgiveness. Therefore, your assignment is in jeopardy. Can anybody get this morning? Your assignment is in jeopardy because you are struggling with what to let in, glory to God, and what to eject or to reject. And the Spirit of God is saying today, it is weariness that causes you to misuse your own heart. Glory to God. Weariness. It causes you to hate what you should love. Anyone with me today? Yes. Weariness causes you to love what you should hate. Weariness causes you to welcome what you should reject. Weariness causes you to open your mind to the wrong things. Weariness causes you to misuse the intellect that God has given you. Weariness causes you to misuse your legs and you walk into the paths of unrighteousness. The Lord God is saying that many of you watching today, your coordination is under attack because the enemy is using weariness against you. Did you get that this morning?
Yes.
When you are tired or weary, your body sends signals. However, the signals are delayed. Your brain becomes a late communicator. Oh my God. Glory to God, it becomes a late communicator. The brain is speaking, the brain is sending messages, but it doesn't late. And there are many of you that are watching today. You got so tired, you become so weary that you did what God told you to do, but you arrived late. And now you are upset and you are angry and you are saying, but God promised me more than this. And the Lord said to tell you, he says, I meet every appointment, glory to God. I meet every appointment. And when you arrive late, you put all that you can receive in that moment in jeopardy. Many of you are arriving late, glory to God. Many of you, can I say that again? You are arriving late. You are arriving late. And the devil is not using the weapons you expected. The enemy is using the underestimated weapon called weariness. Glory to God. You become a late communicator. And the Lord will tell you to do this. The Lord will tell you to do that. and you would reach at the end of the year and you are excited that you are now to December 31st about to embark upon a new year. But the Lord is saying you've come to the end, but you've not finished. Oh, you've not finished. Glory to God. You started, but you didn't finish a lot of things that the Lord told you to do. You started, but you did not finish. You are working like a zombie. Were you? Is this word for anybody out there this morning? You are working like a zombie. You are in, glory to God, you are in the room, but not in position. The Spirit of the Lord God says, he says, this morning I will give you the tactics to defeat weariness. And the Lord God says you will have a testimony. And this testimony will be called, glory to God, I did not miss it. I did not miss what God was doing. The enemy always wants you to be late so that you'll always be saying, I almost had it. I was almost there. I almost made it. But God said, he said, I will give you the power to defeat it. And you will speak out of your mouth that this time I wasn't almost there. Oh my God, but I made it. I did what God wanted me to do. I came out all the way. Glory to God. I came out of my CK. I came out all the way. I need somebody. I'm coming out of my CK. I'm coming out all the way. Glory to God. When you are weary, you mishandle your mouth. Glory to God. You mishandle. You speak what you want to speak, when you want to speak it, where you want to speak it. The Spirit of the Lord is saying today, your irresponsible actions, for many of you, not all, but many of you, is not intentional. But you've been in an hour that you've never seen before. And the devil has inflicted you with weariness. And weariness comes on our lives. Are you ready for this? Weariness comes upon us when we are suffering from repeated cycles, when we've been in something too long. And what weariness comes to do, it comes to destroy our endurance. And he does it by those things I just listed. Glory to God. He comes to destroy our endurance and hence destroy the future that waits on us. The Spirit of the Lord God is saying today, he said, you must fight against weariness. Glory to God. You must fight against weariness. I need somebody to type, I am fighting against weariness. Intercessors are becoming weary. You're praying, but now you're showing up and you said the oil in this moment is no longer here. I said all there is to say. I don't even know what else to pray. And God said you are in a perfect opportunity to now kick into the Spirit. Glory to God. And access your heavenly language. When you get to the point when you don't know what to do, the Lord teaches you a new language. Glory to God. Thank you so much. He teaches you a new language. Intercessors are weary. Pastors are weary. Believers are weary. Business owners are weary. Glory to God. Children are weary. The enemy has inflicted weariness upon us. When now we are praying, and rather than praying according to the will of the Lord, we are saying, God, how long, God? When are you going to change it, God? Is it time yet, God? Are we there yet, God? Can we come out yet, God? And I'm not telling you you're wrong for praying it. If that's your truth, you reveal that unto the Lord. But when you find that that is your language in prayer, you are now under weariness, glory to God. And now you are showing that through your actions. You are in the room, but not in position. You are losing coordination. You, glory to God. You are using, glory to God, I hear you, Father. You are losing your ability to give your assignment, all of you, are the best of you. against weariness. I hear it. Fight against weariness. I have 15 more minutes. I have 15 more minutes. When you are weary, I just want to repeat it again. Your signals are delayed. Your body gives you signals, but glory to God, it is delayed. It comes after the fact. Glory to God. You may have already been in pain for 30 minutes, but 30 minutes after the pain already started, the brain signals to you, you are in pain. And many of you are looking in your household and you are saying, how did I miss this? How did I not see this with my children? How did I not see this with my business? How did I miss this? And the Lord is saying, you've got signals, but you're going late. You've been inflicted with weariness. You got it late. Woo! Now I'm going to share this. This one blew me away. When you are tired, you increase the likeliness of accidents. Things you wouldn't run into, you find yourself running into it. Tiredness, and this is what I have written here, just as God gave it to me in prayer. Tiredness, it makes you run off of the road. And so now as we channel this prophetically, or as we use this according to the prophetic message, the Lord is relaying to us, tiredness can cause you to move off course. Many of you have become tired and weary, and you knew that you didn't have any strength left, and you went the way you wanted to go, and you used everything that you could to justify it. When you become tired, the enemy sends all kind of literature. He sends all kind of random confirmations to now justify the course you are going in. But the Lord never changes mind from the first time he spoke to you. Huh? You tell only certain people about the decisions you're going to make, because you know they are not strong enough to tell you the truth. Oh, glory to God. Glory to God. This morning, the Lord spoke to my spirit, and I heard this question in my spirit. We must examine, why is it that we are withholding our decisions from certain levels of people? Not all the time just because they don't want the best for us. Sometimes the enemy is aiding his own agenda by keeping you away from those people. And you might say, I'm not away from them. But when your decisions are kept in secret, the glory to God, the enemy is keeping you away. There is somebody watching this morning. The Spirit of the Lord God is saying, the people you told about what you're going to do, the reason why everyone has the same answer and response is because all of them are of the same mindset. You need to tell that same person that will tell you the truth, that will let you know you've gone off course. It's the right. God cannot be saying this when he's already said that. Cannot contradict himself, because he's wise. He's, glory to God, he's wise. And so if the Lord said to you, save your money until 2025, you can't come and say, well, the Lord told me I need to make this investment now, but he said save until this date. I know that's not for everybody, but some of you now, you want to move fast and do some things, but the Lord has already given you a word. Glory to God. And I know how the logistics look. Sometimes logical things try to take the place of prophetic things. And the Lord is saying today, make sure the heirs you are trying to speak into, glory to God, they are not just a trusted voice, but they are a trusted ear. That when you speak into the air, they can discern what is of God and what is of haughtiness and presumptuousness. Glory to God. You need somebody to discern when you're too tired to make a decision. You are too devastated to make a decision. Some of you, what you just walked through, you just walked through such a big trial. The decision you want to make right now, you're not even in a position to make that decision.
decision. The Lord is telling you, wait, because your faculties are not even normal yet. You are so devastated by your loss. You are so devastated by what you walk through. You can never see it through the eyes of truth. Now you're only seeing through the eyes of pain and the eyes of hurt. Glory to God. The reason why you're unable to make, glory to God, the reason why you're unable to make certain decisions, the reason why you want to make certain decisions is because you are still looking through the eyes of pain. When you are still hurting over a matter, glory to God, when you are still hurting over a matter, you need somebody else to come in that can say to you, this is unforgiveness that is speaking. This is hurt that is speaking. This is bitterness. You're not ready to say no to this. You're not ready to say yes to this. You're not ready yet. Anybody with me this morning? Trials make you tired. When you are in a thing for so long, or you've already experienced a thing before, and now you are going through it again. Can anybody bear witness with this today? He said, I've walked through something, and now I'm walking through it again. And I find myself going through it a third time. I find myself here a fourth time. It makes you weary. The enemy releases weariness upon you. When now you are not seeing through the eyes of truth, you are seeing through the eyes of tiredness and pain. You can run off of the road. A tired person cannot drive their own car for a while. Every now and again, you gotta pull over and sleep. You gotta ask somebody else to take the wheel. Oh my God. You gotta be grown enough. You gotta be mature enough. You gotta be willing enough to allow somebody else to take the wheel, who's more stable in the moment, who can help you devise through this season, who will tell you the truth and won't have their own agenda, who will not stroke your flesh, who'll tell you when you went off course, who'll tell you, I know it sounds like God, but it cannot be God, because I know the last word you got and it's contradicting the first one. Anybody with me today? Anybody? Woo! My God, my God. When you are tired, you can't drive because you are more prone to accidents. Even the best drivers cannot drive when they are tired. You will run off of the road. And there are some of you today, you've been in a trial for so long, you become weary. And you find yourself running off of the road. You find yourself no longer on the course that the Lord has set you on. You are doing everybody else's assignment, and you've not done what God had you to do yet. Glory to God. You are praying about all kinds of things, but you've not yet submitted the thing that God told you to give over to Him yet. You are weary and you are tired, and the enemy is trying to keep you in the state of being tired and lost. And so, glory to God, the Lord began to minister to me this morning through an experience that I had. I was driving and I was tired. I was so tired. Glory to God, I was so tired that I just pulled over and I just, oh glory to God, I parked the car and I said, I'm going to sleep for about 30 minutes. I'm going to sleep for about 30 minutes. I texted someone and I told them where I was. I said, I just need to pull over and I need to sleep for about a few minutes. I'm dozing off. I'm falling asleep while I'm driving. Glory to God. Glory to God. And while I was driving, when I woke up, I realized now I'm more alert and I feel more rested. That I don't even know where I parked. I said, God, where is this place that I've been sleeping for 30 minutes? Glory to God. I looked around and I said, if my mind was in a better state, I would have never, ever parked in this place. Y'all with me today? I would have never parked in this place. It doesn't look safe. There's no lighting around me. And I said, I had to have really been out of it because I don't even know the name of this street. I am in an unfamiliar place. And if anybody needs to come and find me, I don't even know how to direct them where I am. And the Lord began to speak to me this morning out of this. And the Lord said, tell people that when you are too tired and when you are weary, need you to drive, glory to God. And if I fall asleep while we're driving, I know that we'll still be steering on the right course. It's okay to tell somebody, I need you to tell me what to do, because I trust the God that is in your life. I need you to pray with me, because I know that I love God. I know that the hand of God is upon me, but I've been going through this thing for a while, and now I am weary, and I'm afraid to make the wrong decision. It's too expensive to decide wrong now. I need you to walk me through this. I'm not mentally capable. Glory to God. I'm not mentally capable. I'm not emotionally capable. I'm not even spiritually capable. I don't even know what I'm hearing right now. Anyone out there today? Ooh, glory to God. Every now and again, for some of you, you may say, I don't even have that person in my immediate circle. Well, then what you need to do is pause and say, Jesus, take the wheel. I'm not going to move until you said a word. Not a word that I conjured up or I made up. I'm not going to move until you send a confirmation from a man or woman of God that I know you are speaking through. Speak to me in my dream. Speak to me through your word. Send your prophet. But I'm not going to move until you speak to me. I know the state that I'm in. And this trial has made me so weary, I can run off the road. Give me just pause and give God a praise for about 10 seconds. Oh, glory to God. Oh, glory to God. The mandala mancia. For the mandala mancia. Candala mancia. For the mancia. Candala mancia. The mandala mando. Tiredness is the result of your weariness. The enemy is trying to make you weary, and you are too close now. How can you be weary in a pandemic and your family needs you? Your future needs you. This time is too pivotal for you to get too weary now to function. Glory to God. The Lord says to tell you, too many people are depending on you. Glory to God. Glory to God. Thank you so much. The Lord ministered to me through the story of Samson. And I believe that there is an underestimated factor in this story. And one of the factors we overlook is not really that he was in love, because the word of the Lord said he was in love with her from the very beginning. And even though he was in love with her from the very beginning, he did not reveal his secret. One of the factors we underestimate in this story, again, is not that he was in love, is that she made him weary. Glory to God. Delilah made Samson weary. I want to walk you through this experience the way God revealed it to me. He met a beautiful woman. She was fine. She talked right. She looked right. And he loved her. He took a liking to her. He did so that, glory to God, they spent many nights together from the early onset of their relationship. But he was ready for her. And when I say he was ready, I wrote it down in my notes. I wrote it down in my notes that he was ready for her. Because from the beginning, she began to question him about the secret of his strength. And the word of the Lord said he would always give her a story to throw her off. The question she was asking him, it was a strange one. Don't you agree? It was not about his fantasy. It was not about how many parts. morning that he was not willing to disobey God by telling her his secret. Time and time again, he told her the wrong story, hoping that she would leave it alone. Glory to God. Hoping that she would leave it alone. But this woman, she had been promised a great reward by his enemies. And she wanted to know the secret that made him strong. I want to pause right there. There are many of you in this hour. You believe, glory to God. You believe that in order to disobey God, it is when you fornicate or only commit adultery. And yes, it is wrong and the Bible speaks against it. But the Lord God said it's not only when you tell a lie or not only when you steal from your brother. But the Lord said many of you, you are speaking out of turn for many years. From you as a child, you went through the toughest of the tough. And there are some secrets I reveal to you. And it is between you and I. There is a secret to your strength that you cannot allow your enemy to know. Somebody shout, yes! Yes! There is a secret to your strength. She wanted to know what makes you strong. Oh, I'm telling you today, the enemy was waiting for this moment. Oh, the enemy always wanted to know what makes you strong, what keeps you going. Oh, when you've been through so much, when you've been neglected by your family, when you've been through embarrassing things that you cannot even tell others about, what makes you so strong? Enemy, glory to God. The enemy has been watching you from you were released out of the womb, watching you overcome that sickness, watch you while you were stuttering as a child, and watch how God delivered you, and watch how you went through poverty, abandonment, and watch how you went through mind battles, how you lost relationships, and you didn't know what to do. It does not reveal the secret. Many of you didn't even grow up in church. Many of you, it looks like you did not have that foundation. So the question is, what is making you so strong? Oh God, when you were counted out even in your classroom, nobody even knew the rejection you dealt with. Nobody knew. Oh, how your heart would be ripping in pieces. Many of you have been asking the question silently, can somebody love me for me? You walked through it. You succeeded through it. You kept going through it. And the devil keeps asking, what is making her or him so strong? This woman, she wanted to know what makes Samson so strong. His family background does not reveal the secret. Oh, glory to God. There's nowhere we can study. There is nowhere we can look. But the Lord reveals something to me through this. He said, there are some fibers of your life that you don't even know why God had it there. You don't even know why God did it that way. It is the secret to your strength. Glory to God. The Lord says, glory to God, you must be careful when you choose to be weak. The devil's been waiting a long time to get you in this place where he can see you in your vulnerable moment. I'm not telling you to be perfect. I'm telling you to make sure you are safe when you choose to be weak. The Lord says the devil has been asking what has been making him or her so strong. She wanted to know the secret that gave him all the victories. I just need about, I need 500 of you, because I feel God. My God, I feel God. Glory to God. I feel God. What is the secret to all of his victories? I was in prayer this morning and the Lord said, there are some people that will be watching you. Oh, they didn't grow up in much. They didn't have much. But God just keep doing it for them. He kept making ways out of no ways for them. You were not the choice of many, but you were the choice of God. Even when you fell down, he kept picking you back up. Things that people never recovered from, That one minute she wants to give up on God, but the next minute she's back on track again. One minute she wants nothing to do with ministry and God, the next minute she's back on track. One minute the whole host of hell is after their house, is after their family. And when we believe we're about to take this bloodline down, we get the edict from heaven that tells hell, stand down, don't move, don't go any closer. And I want to know, who is this person? Who are you? You may not even have any degrees. You don't have any money. You're not a king. You're not a queen. Why are you so victorious? Who are you that you will have all of these victories? Can anybody be a witness with this? Who are you that you can have all of these victories? Many people believe the victory is not ever having to cry. Many of you believe the victory is not ever having to lose anybody. Many of you believe the victory is never ever experiencing a trial. But can I tell you what a victory is? A victory is when you go in a trial that's so bad, you go in a trial that's so big, it shakes you to the core, but you're alcohol. It holds on the solid rock. It shakes you to the core. You're tempted to doubt God, but what you share with God, you can never go there. You come out of your trial with your faith. You come out with your praise. You come out with your emotions intact. That is a victory. That is a victory. That is a victory. Oh, that is a victory. Oh, glory to God. Oh, glory to God. Oh, glory to God. There are some people watching me today. You are moving from place to place. You are mistreated in other people's household. I don't know why God is sending me here today. And then people, they try to manipulate you and say, I'm this to you. But you watched the way they treated you and you knew you can't be a mother. You can't be a father. You can't be a protector. Because this is what you're doing. The Spirit of the Lord God said, and you came out and you became a safe place for them that are weak. You are battered and bruised and you became a defender. Oh glory to God. And there are some of you, you had to face it with tears in your eyes. You had to face it with your heart broken. And you said, God, I don't know what to do. Anybody watching me today that went in a trial with no manual, that went in a trial and you didn't know what to do. You said, I'm going to lose this. I've never been here before. There's no way I can come out of this. I've never been this way before. But you came out and you're stronger now than you were before. You got some bruises. You were disappointed, but you got the victory. Glory to God. You got the victory. Glory to God. Oh, can we just give God glory? Oh. And the Lord began to minister to me. And the Lord said, Tammy, the victory is not in that you never have to go through it. Anybody watching me today, you're in a trial right now. You just had a loss. You were disappointed and you're wondering what next, God. The Lord ministered to me. He said, glory to God. He said that the victory is not that you never experience it. He said the victory is, even if you experience it, you come out with your mind intact. You come out with your faith intact. You come out with your praise intact. And you can allow God to get the glory out of your life. Because you say, had it not been for the Lord that was on my side, I would have been swallowed up. I would have been a mere memory. Oh, but all of my life, he keeps protecting me. All of my life, he keeps showing me favor. He keeps showing me grace. He keeps showing me mercy. Can I ask glory the love of God. She wanted to know, what is the secret to all of his victories?
My God.
Oh, and the enemy entered into an organized plan.
My God.
The attack against Samson's strength. See, hear me today. Yes, many of you are in a fight for your life, but you are in a fight for your strength.
Yeah.
Oh, glory to God. The attack against Samson's strength increased gradually. Let me know if you can hear us clearly today. It increased gradually. What do you mean, prophetess? She began by starting on the entry level. This entry level is called the curious phase. She began to ask him, can you tell me what makes you strong? Can you tell me what makes you strong? Can you tell me how you're doing this? Can you tell me how you're doing that? And I want to repeat this in the defense of Samson. He came prepared. He came prepared for Delilah. He refused to let his guard down every time he kept his secret safe. And so she saw that that didn't work. So she went to the next level. And the next level is called the questioning or the manipulation phase. She then said to him, she said, she questioned his love. She said, how can you say you love me? And I just want to say it the way God gave it to me. The Lord says no one wants their love, their purpose, or their intent to ever be questioned. And many of you are in the midst of something right now that someone is trying to get you to make a decision. And they're questioning your call from God. They're questioning your love. They're questioning your loyalty. And that's what she did to Samson. She questioned him and she said, how can you confide in me if you love me? Before she was saying, why are you making a fool of me? But then she went to another level and she said, if you love me, how can you say you love me and not confide in me? And then she went to an intensified level I call the third phase. This is called the phase of repetition. The word of the Lord said she nagged him day after day after day. Anybody with me today? She nagged him. In my translation, it said she probed him. When I looked at the word probe, it means to push or to poke. She pushed him to his limit. Y'all with me today? She knew what made him angry. She knows what can make him give in. And she pushes him to the point. The Lord is saying the enemy is trying to push you over the edge. You got to hold your ground and stand firm. This fight is not accidental. It is strategic. What is coming up against you is strategic. The enemy knows how to get you out of your glory to God. Out of the safe place. Glory to God. The enemy knows how to push you over the limit. For some of you, it's the right words. For others, it's just the right acts. For some of you, it's distance for a while. That'll get you not just to give up. Because when I looked at give up, give glory to God. Give up means to concede. Glory to God, it means to concede. But to give in means to turn yourself over. The enemy wants you to give up and to give in. He knows how to get you to do what he studied you. Glory to God. That's why God is trying to push you. That's why he's trying to strengthen your emotions. Because you keep breaking under certain pressurized situations. And God is pushing you beyond that point. Because the devil always uses that against you. Anyone with me today? Anyone out there today, the devil keeps using you against you?
Yes.
I gotta say that again. The devil keeps using you against you. Sometimes he don't send any sickness. He don't send money problems. He makes you frustrated. He makes you aggravated. And the same response he would have gotten had those things happen, he got it anyway.
Yes.
Anyone with me today? day.
Yes.
So she nagged him. She moved into the phase of repetition. And that's where some of you are this morning. You said, it's been 5 years, Lord. I've been here for 5 years. This thing keeps happening to me, Lord. God, I don't know. I don't know if I can wait another month. I don't know if I can wait. I don't know if I can obey you in this. I don't know if I can trust you in this. I don't know if I can give in my right for the wrong in this. Anyone out there today?
Yes.
And she pushed him. And she nagged him. She did it so. The word of the Lord said he was sick unto death. He didn't have diabetes. He didn't have cancer. He was in a cycle. The repetition, it made him weak to the point that he was sick. Anyone with me today? Delilah made Samson weary. I want to share this with you. The word of the Lord says, and this is what God gave me for you today. I'm closing. The word of the Lord says in Isaiah 54, and I'm paraphrasing, and the Lord has given me the tongue of the learned for weariness. Let me just say that again. Isaiah 54, it says, and the Lord has given me the tongue of the learned to defeat weariness. What are you trying to say? What are you trying to say? At the beginning of this study, at this teaching, one of the things we learned is that tiredness is caused through dehydration. Right. And the Spirit of the Lord began to show me the resource of water and what all it does to the body and how water can mean so many prophetic things. And one of the things, y'all with me today, one of the things I realized that Samson was not in a safe place. And I begin to wonder, this man should have realized he was not safe because she kept asking him the same question. Not only did she keep asking him the same question, but when she asked him, she would even try to tie him up. And when she would try to tie him up, she would then try his strength by saying, the Philistines is upon you. It was almost obvious that this person had an agenda. Why did he give in? Are you with me today? The Spirit of the Lord said to me, he said, Samson, he was away from home. Glory to God. He was away from home. He was away from the people that loved him. He was away from the people that was pushing him, the people that were truly supporting him. He was away from those people, and he resided in a dangerous place. My God. He resided in a dangerous place. And so the Lord said, he had no one in that place to give him the word of the Lord. He had no one in that place to remind him of the word of the Lord. And so then God began to minister to me. And the Lord said, he said, the weapon that the Lord uses against weariness. Are you ready for it? The weapon that God uses against weariness is the word of God. Isaiah 54 says that God has given me the tongue of the learned to defeat weariness. The Spirit of the Lord says, he says, when you are weak, when you are tired, you don't need a positive word. You don't need an optimistic word. You need a prophetic word. You need a word from God. Because if it comes from God, built in the word is the resources that you need. Whether it's a rebuke, whether it's hard instructions, you need the word of God. You need the word of God. In my closing today, the Spirit of the Lord said the weary needs the word of God. The weary needs the word of God. My question to you today is, will you listen? The weary need glory to God. The weary needs the word from God. Will you listen today? The Spirit of the Lord said to tell you. He said, don't give up now. The reason why you shouldn't give up now. Are you ready for this? He said, tell everybody today that's watching and you feel weary. He said, glory to God. He said, the 12 disciples, they had a glory after this moment. He said, Moses, he had a glory after this moment. He said, Elijah had a glory after this moment. And the Lord says, I know you are weary. I know you want to give up. I know it may get worse before it gets better. But the Lord said to tell everybody that is weary this morning. He said, there will be glory after this. There will be glory after this. The Lord said, use all your strength to get to the after this. The Lord said, you cannot stay in now because the after this is waiting. Glory to God. He said, the after this is waiting. Glory to God. He said, the after this. He said, the after this is waiting. I need about, come quickly. I need about 500 of you to begin typing now. The after this is waiting. The after this is waiting. Glory to God. The Lord says, do not allow offense. Do not allow a familiar thing to move you out of your new thing from God. The Lord says, tiredness is making you make the wrong decisions. The Spirit of the Lord said, he said, come in. You need water. He said, you need water. Intercessors, the Lord, he spoke to me today, and God says, you need water. Glory to God. This is how we're going to get it. The Lord God says, he said, now you got to do it for you. He says, now you got to cry out for you. Now you must chase him for you. Glory to God. You must chase for the oil of the Lord to fall on your head. And I hear the Lord God say, your spirit is dehydrated. You need water. Glory to God. You need water. Glory to God. You need the tongue of the Lord. You need the spirit of wisdom that will tell you what you want to hear. But they'll tell you the word of the Lord. And the Lord God say, I will give you water. I will give you water. Come into me. Come into me. Come into me. And tell me. I don't know what to do. I don't know where to go. And the Lord says, I will answer your prayer. Out of your belly will flow. Out of your belly will flow. Out of your belly will flow rivers of living water. I know what you get right now is heavy. The Lord God says you need water. Lord, let it rain over our house. Let it rain in our prayer rooms. Let it rain in our season. 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 He said, you need water. The Lord God says, you need water. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You need water. How do I get water? I get it by receiving a fresh touch of the Holy Ghost, of his Holy Spirit. That's how I get it. Many of us, we are praying in public but not in private. The Lord says, I don't want your public submission. I need your private submission. Glory to God. The Lord says, many of us, we are doing it in public. I guess the people needs it. So many needs it. But the Lord says, do it in private so that you can be replenished. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. The enemy is trying trying to move you off course. You're praying for a job, but you should be praying for fresh oil and a spring of water. And I'm not telling you not to desire to work. I'm just telling you it's already yours. And I'm telling you when you need more, what you need more, glory to God. What you need more is His Spirit. You should say, take not your Holy Spirit from me. Glory to God. Glory to God. The crown of your head this morning. To the sole of your feet. Hallelujah. May you have dreams. May the Lord give you visions of confirmation. May you receive strength in your spirit this morning. May your limbs be revitalized this morning. May your intellect be reskilled this morning. May the Lord empower you with glory this morning. May the Lord give you the resources of heaven. That's not even known to the natural eye. May the Lord give you rain of strength and abundance. May the Lord God give you abundant life this morning. For the thief comes to kill, steal, and destroy. Many of us, we are victims of the thief who has come and robbed us of our peace, robbed us of our strength. But the Lord has come to give you life. Not just life, but life to another level. Life more abundantly. Life more abundantly. But the Lord has come to give you life more abundantly. And may you prosper evenly as your soul prosper. I pray for your mind today. That the thoughts to concede, to give up and give in, it will be far away from you. And the hedges of the Lord God will be placed around your mind in the name of Jesus. May the hedges of the Lord be around your air. Glory to God. May the hedges of the Lord be around your air. Glory to God. Glory to God. May the hedges of the Lord be around your ear. Glory to God. I pray that the sound of the Lord that is in your belly, the Lord, will reserve in a safe place. In the name of Jesus, you will not wail while you're tired. You will not cry while you're tired. The Lord hears the cry of the weepers. The Lord will strengthen you again to wail in the spirit. He will strengthen you again to weep. May we man the gates at the courts. May we man the gates at the courts. May we man the gates at the courts. May we man the gates at the court of the Lord. At the court of the Lord. May we man the gates at the courts. In the name of Jesus. We will not get weary. We won't faint. I decree that you will not faint this morning. You won't be weary in well-doing. That's a level of weariness the enemy puts on people that are producing in the earth. The enemy is after fruit bearers. That you even become weary in well-doing. And I decree and I declare, you will not be weary in well-doing. But every fruit bearer that is watching me this morning, may the Lord endow you with strength. May the command of the Lord, may it be your portion in the name of the Lord Jesus. In the name of Jesus, may we have ancient oil. in Genoa that teaches us how to navigate the familiar plans of the enemy. God, may we have fresh oil that teaches us how to navigate the times that our generation have never seen before. Lord God, we ask you today, we ask you for the ears of the Lord. Open up our ears, activate our ears, that we may, yes God, we may hear the instructions in the spirit realm. Oh God, activate the trumpet that opens the gates. Activate the trumpet that calls and assembles the warriors to war. Activate the horn of the Lord, that when we blow ye the trumpet in Zion, we will get now results. Lord, the intercessors that are weary this morning, blow, blow, blow. Blow a fresh wind. Blow a fresh wind over them this morning. Your people, your parents, men and women of God, parents, pastors, prophets, apostles, believers of God, nations, governments that are weary. Lord, you sent prophets to prevent weariness. You sent prophets to prevent crisis. Lord, you know that Pharaoh was unable to man Egypt in the time that was coming. He may have loved his job, but he didn't know how. You sent a prophet to give him a strategy. Lord, I pray today that you give our governments prophetic strategy. God, that you release prophets that they can trust. Prophets that won't have their own agenda. Prophets that they can trust. That will pray without ceasing until you release the manual. I thank you for the lifting day. Glory to God. May you lift our days, glory to God. May you lift the darkness off of our days. May you lift the darkness off of our days. Lord, we thank you for strength being released on this broadcast this morning. We thank you for the strength of the Lord. Not just strength. Thank you for the strength of the Lord. Thank you, thank you, thank you. For the word of the Lord, which is translated through the tongue of the learned, it's not just talking about someone with a degree or intellect, but someone that knows what to do because you told them what to do myself. Father, I pray today that you release the anointing of an amen over our prayer. That as we decree and we declare over our families and our nation, we can confidently say it is so. The it is so of the Lord. May you release us into the it is so of the Lord. Cover every person that is watching today. Every person that is praying, every person that is watching, every person that is praying, every person that is waiting, every person that is believing. I pray that you cover even the fearful today, and I pray that you protect them and defeat the spirit of fear that's trying to release them in wariness and conquer their mind. That we won't move impulsively because we are afraid. You're pushing many of us to the limit in the way we know things work. We are crying for it to happen like that. But it cannot work in a time like this. Teach us your strategies of today. That we won't cry out for the old thing. Glory to God. Pull us to where you are. According to your will for this time. Cover the fearful today, God. Cover those that are contemplating giving up and giving in. Those that have suffered loss, those that are sick in their bodies, those that are believing God for somebody that is weak or that is sick this morning. May you cover us. May you cover us. Can we take a few seconds and begin to bless the name of the Lord? We give you glory in this place. give you glory in this moment. We give you glory in this moment. We honor you in this moment, God. We honor you in this moment. Hallelujah. We honor you in this moment, God. We honor you in this moment, Jesus. We honor you, God. We show you honor, God. We show you honor, God. We show you honor, Father. We show you honor. We won't relent. We won't turn away from our assignment, Lord God. We will stay on course. We will not allow weariness to come into our lives, Father. We will seek you, oh glory to God. We will receive of you. Yes, Lord. We will receive from the word of God, not the word of our flesh and the impulses. We show you honor, Father.
Struggle to focus.
You will not lose focus on the will of the Lord. You will not struggle to learn new things. But even now, your spirit is ready. Your intellect is ready. Your prophetic instinct is ready to receive the now downloads of the Lord. Again, you will not lose coordination. You will use your mouth, your eyes, your ears. You will use it with newness and precision. You will have new and potent glory to God and potent strength. You will have victories you've never seen before. Are you ready for this? You will not have delayed signals. Your prophetic instinct, your understanding, it will function above the expected level. Glory to God. You will not go off course. You will not go off course. Can somebody type, I'm not moving off course. Lastly, I pray today, you will not underestimate the enemy. You will see the weapons for what they are. When the enemy tries to be cunning, to study your weakness, I decree and I declare that your weakness will become your strength. And will not be used in the hand of the enemy as a wielding sword against your future. May the Lord defeat the plans of the enemy against you. And the people of God say. And the people of God say.
Amen.
Okay, let me make this last declaration. The secrets God has given you to make money. The secrets God has given you to be strong. The secrets God has given you to prosper in the midst of a hard time. The enemy will not take your secrets, distort them, and cause them to lose its value. Someone shout yes.
Yes.
Someone shout yes.
Yes.
I decree and I declare in this hour, you will not be manipulated out of the will of the Lord. Every person that is being paid by the enemy, used by the enemy to manipulate you, may they lose their skill and their strategy. May they function as if they are senseless in the name of Jesus. I pray your strength will remain intact. You will not lose anything in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Your emotions will remain intact. Your mental capability will remain intact. And the people of God say,
amen.
Can we shout right there?
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah.
Glory to God!
Hallelujah.
And it is so. I'm going to see you tomorrow. We'll let you know the timing. That we will be on tomorrow. I'm so excited about all that God is doing. Pastor Trevor Simmons sends his love. I give you my love. Thank you for all the Lord is doing, and all the Lord is using you to do. Some of you, your words of encouragement, it does not go unnoticed. Thank you so much. Once again, may we move in the strength of this word. Go in the strength of this word for many days. I'm going to let you go now. I know it's your Sunday. I'm going to let you go now. Blessings upon you. We love you. Enjoy your day.